and will graduate in December 2023 with her bachelor's degree in history and a minor in anthropology. Thank you for all your hard work and dedication to the women's basketball program. Fans, please put your hands together for Beth Woodring. Please welcome to the court, number 3, Takesia Barnes. Takesia is being escorted now by her teammates. Barnes started her collegiate career and spent 3 seasons at Harris Stowe State. This is her first season at West Alabama. Barnes has played in 27 games this season and accumulated 63 points and 63 rebounds. Fans, please put your hands together for number 3, Takesia Barnes. Put your hands together for number 24, Ella Noble. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the court, Shayla Williams. Williams is being escorted out by her parents, Larissa and Rashawn Robinson, and her brother, RJ Robinson. Shayla has been at University of West Alabama for 5 seasons. During her time as a Tiger, she has played in 96 games and accumulated 734 points. She has grabbed 338 rebounds and dished out 393 assists and made 135 steals. Williams averaged 11 points a game and 6 assists. She is leading the Tigers and the GSC in assists this season with 157. Williams scored a season high of 23 points against Valdosta State this past Thursday. Fans, one more time, put your hands together for number 10, Shayla Williams. Fans, please welcome to the court number 33, Zoe Watts. She has been escorted by her parents, Gina and Stephen Watts. Watts played in 95 games and has accumulated 815 points during her time as a Tiger. She has collected 371 rebounds and made 81 steals, dished out 54 assists, and 58 blocks over 4 seasons. Watts is averaging 10 points per game. Watts scored a season high of 21 points against Christian Brothers on January 1st. Fans, one more time, let's give a hand to number 34, Zoe Watts. Tiger fans, please welcome to the court, Bria Zitz. Bria is being escorted by her parents, Robert and Lorenzo Diaz. Dick has played in 125 games, accounted for 1,762 points, 1,265 rebounds over 5 seasons. She has posted 63 double-doubles during her time as a Tiger. This season, Dick averaged 19 points a game and 11 rebounds. Dent scored a career high of 33 points at West Georgia this season on February 11th. She grabbed a season high of 19 rebounds on January 2nd against Christian Brothers. She is leading the conference in points and ranked 2nd in the GSC in rebounds. Fans, please put your hands together for number 2, Bria Zitz. ladies and gentlemen, will we now be honoring our men's basketball seniors. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the court number 0, Shadarian Allen. Shadarian is the escorted out by his father, Benjamin Henry, dad, Kendall Allen, and brother, Ken Davis. Allen played in 72 games and accumulated 975 points during his time in 3 seasons as a Tiger. He's collected 424 rebounds, dished out 125 assists, and 91 steals. Allen averages 14.2 points per game and 6 rebounds per game. Allen scored a season high of 24 points against West Georgia on February 11th. Fans, please put your hands together for Shadarian Allen! Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome now to the court, Justin Allison! Allison is being escorted by his parents, Sam and Jeff Allison, brother Zachary Allison, and sister Jordan Allison. Allison has played in 99 games and accumulated 1,035 points over 4 seasons at West Alabama, has collected 408 rebounds, dished out 255 assists, made 115 steals during his time as a Tiger. Allison is averaging 13.2 points per game this season. He scored a season high of 22 against Lee University on January 26th. Fans, please put your hands together for number 2, Justin Allison. Fans, let's get one more big round of applause for this senior class from the University of West Alabama men's basketball team. Ladies and gentlemen, will we now be honoring our senior cheerleaders? Ladies and gentlemen, now entering the room, Carly Cameron. Carly is from Aliceville, Alabama, and has been on the cheer team for 3 years. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give another round of applause for Carly Cameron. Next up is Kamaya Walker. Walker is from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, and is being escorted onto the court by her family. She's from Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Kamaya has been on the cheer team for the last 2 years. Please give a round of applause for Kamaya Walker. Ladies and gentlemen, Jasmine Brooks. Brooks is from Collinsville, Mississippi, and she has been on the West Alabama cheer team for 2 years. Ladies and gentlemen, Jasmine Brooks! Folks, let's get one last round of applause for our West Alabama cheer team seniors.
My mama calls, say you on TV, so You don't like it. You don't like it. don't have it right in front of me. I do have to look that up, though. Bria's going to come up at halftime. Bria. Wayne, I'm ready whenever you are. What was that? Gymnasium, as we're just a few minutes away from West Alabama men's basketball taking on the Argonauts of West Florida. West Alabama took on West Florida earlier this season. The Tigers won 60-52 down in Pensacola. A pivotal game in Gulf South Conference play as this is the last game of the regular season. West Alabama tied for the top spot in the Gulf South Conference and hoping to go into the Gulf South Conference Tournament as the number one seed. This is a big meeting between these two teams. 2 minutes away from getting things started here. West Alabama is 19-17 against West Florida. The Tigers are 12-8 here in Pruitt Hall Gymnasium. It's a big matchup for both teams as we're about to get things underway. West Florida is in the ninth spot, not able to make it into the Gulf South Conference Tournament. So this is their final game of the season. West Alabama tied up with Alabama Huntsville for that top spot. As we are about to get things underway, Nick Woodruff, the head coach for West Alabama, on the far side, talking to Jake Jobling, his assistant. Jake was a great player here at West Alabama. We're not far from getting things underway. Waiting to get our starting lineup as we're not far away from getting things started. Great crowd on hand, a lot of the football team here. And boy, they're ready to see some fun. They bring a tremendous atmosphere to Pruitt Gym here. West Alabama heading over to the bench. Tigers come into the game 18-5 in Gulf South Conference play, 22-5 overall. Waiting on our live stats to load. Let's talk about our seniors for a minute. We just had senior day just between the two games. Our first senior for the men was Shadarian Allen. He played in 72 games. He has 975 points in three seasons here at West Alabama. He has 424 rebounds, 125 assists. Justin Allison, another senior. He's accumulated 1,035 points in 99 games and 408 rebounds. He's dished out 255 assists, 115 steals, and scored a season-high points against Lee University on the 26th. Justin's been a big player here for West Alabama. Shadarian as well. Of course, we can remember back just not too long ago whenever Justin hit that big shot to send West Alabama to Birmingham for the semifinals of the Gulf South Conference Tournament.
My apologies, ladies and gentlemen. We will not be doing the national anthem for this game.
Starting lineup for West Florida. Number 3, Latrell Tate. Number 12, Jared DeHart. Number 21, Daniel Sofield. Number 4, Wendell Matthews. And number 11, Dave Petit-Home. For West Alabama, number 1, C.J. Melton. Number 2, Justin Allison. Number 22, Thad Williams. Number 0, Shadarian Allen. And number 5, Terry Durham. All five starters have played in 27 games. Leading scorer of the starters is Justin Allison with 13.2. 7.6 rebounds for Terry Durham. Talk to season comparison. This is going to be a very close game. West Georgia's averaged 72.1 points per game. West Alabama 72.9. So both of these teams have been very, very close. Both shooting over 30% from beyond the arc. Shooting right at 44% for the field goal. And West Alabama shooting 76%. West Florida 75% from beyond the arc. We're wrapping up starting lineups as we are not far away from this big game for West Alabama. Great crowd on hand as we are getting things underway. 11:01 remaining in the first half. Alabama Huntsville leads Valdosta State 18-16. That will be a big game for us here. So we, of course, would like to see Valdosta State win that and give West Alabama the outright championship for the regular season. Great crowd on hand, WTOK on hand. Ready to see a chance for the Tigers with a win. Could cut down the nets for at least a share of the regular season championship with a win and possibly an outright championship. As we are set to get things underway, CJ steps into the circle for West Alabama for the jump against number 4, Taylor. And we are underway. West Alabama gets the tip, and Thad takes the point. Thad's going to dribble to his left as the Tigers are going left to right on your radio dial. They get it around to Justin on the near side. He tries to get it to CJ, but it's knocked out of bounds by Taylor. Justin inbounds it to Thad. Thad's going to dribble to his left, work off of the screen. Give it to CJ on the far side. Back up top to Thad, to Shadarian. Shadarian guarded closely by Taylor. They give it down low to Durham. His shot's up, no good. Rebound, West Florida. Durham takes a hard spill onto the floor. And down low quickly, they get it to number 4. Taylor, his shot is up and good, and West Florida leads 2-0, 19-18 remaining here in the first half. Williams taking it across half court for the Tigers. Guarded closely as they give it to Allison on the far side. Back to Williams up top. To Shadarian just inside the arc. He takes a shot. It's up and good. And West Alabama ties it up 2-2. Shadarian gets his 277th point of his career here at West Alabama. Taylor has it on the far side. Gives it down low to Stubble. He throws it over to the near side. And the shot is up and good. Oh. Shadarian has it, kicks it out to Justin. It goes off his fingertips and to the far side, and it's a turnover. West Alabama. Petit Holm made that shot for West Florida. Makes it a 5-2 ball game. Sofield has it on the far side, gives it to Matthews. Matthews back to Sofield. He shoots a three. It's up and good. And the score is now 8-2, 17:58 remaining in the first half. Allison taking it across half court. Gives it to Williams. Back to the far side to Allison. He dribbles off a screen from Allen. Gives it to Williams. Works it back to Allen. He's been double teamed. Now he shoots. Shots up. No good. We've got a foul on the play. Dell Matthews, number four, with the foul. That'll be his first, team first. Was not a shooting foul. Was on the floor. Justin inbounds it to Durham. He gets it back to Justin. He shoots it, rattles around, and it's good. The score is 5-8. West Florida leads 17-26 remaining. Matthews has it, kicks it to the outside. Quick jumper. For a three for Sofield, it's no good. West Alabama gets a rebound. CJ takes it across half court. He's going to dribble all the way around to the right side. Give it to Terry Durham down bottom. Durham backing it in. Tries to get it out to CJ, but it's knocked out of bounds by West Florida. 17:04 remaining in the first half. 5-8 your score. West Florida leads by three. Allison will inbound it on the baseline. Allen. Back to Allison. Allison shoots a three. It's no good. West Florida gets it, and they quickly work it downfield. Shots up, no good. But rebound put back in is Dell Matthews. And the score is 5-10. Williams takes it across half court. Gets it to Allison. Allison guarded closely by DeHart. DeHart denies him as it's kicked out to CJ. To Shadarian, to Thad, over to the far side to Allison. He's going to take a few steps in. Kick it out to Williams. 3 seconds left on the shot clock. Williams takes a shot. It's up. It's good. 7-10, your new score. Tigers down by three. 16-16 remaining in the first half. DeHart has it on the far side. He's going to kick it out. Kicks it out to number three, Latrell. Out to DeHart again. Back to Matthews. Matthews to Sofield. His shot's up, no good. Justin Allison comes up with the rebound. Takes it across half court. 15:15 remaining in the first half. Three's up, no good. Rebound. DeHart for West Florida. He's picked up quickly by Williams. Williams gives it to Matthews. Back over to Sofield, back to Matthews. His shot's no good. Justin gets a rebound, takes it across half court. Working quickly around to CJ. CJ shoots a three. It's up. It's good. We've got a tied ball game. 15-17 remaining here in the first half. Nice work by West Alabama working the ball around the arc. Matthews has it. He's going to kick it out to Petit Holm. Petit Holm drives in, and it's out of bounds off of Petit Holm. We've got a media timeout. We're all knotted up 10-10, 15:01 remaining here in the first half. You're listening to West Alabama basketball on the West Alabama Radio Network. Welcome back to Pruitt Gymnasium. 15:01 remaining here in the first half. West Alabama 10, West Florida 10. I'm Jason Gardner, bringing you West Alabama basketball action. Filling in for Will Atkinson today. CJ throws it in to Thad. Thad's going to set the offense and bring it across half court. West Alabama shooting 50%. So is West Florida. Justin has it on the near side. Back to Williams. Williams fakes it. Down low, puts it back to Allison. Back to Williams, to the far side to CJ. CJ looking, seeing where he can find someone. Gives it to Shadarian. Down low to Terry. Terry's shot is not good, but he will head to the free throw line. That foul's on number 11, David Petit-Holm. His first, team second. Terry's shot is up and good. Terry shooting 63% from the line as he misses that one. West Florida gets the rebound. DeHart has it, dribbles to his right. Gives it to Tate. Tate to Sofield. The ball is knocked away, picked up by Shadarian. Shadarian gives it to Thad. Thad back to Shadarian. No good. Shots back up and good. 13-10 your score. 14-14 remaining in the game. Tigers tossing the ball back and forth, back under the rim. Looking for that open shot. Tate shoots a three. It is no good, but he is going down. Actually, they say it was a two. And that foul is going to be on number five, Terry Durham. That'll be his first, team first. 13:59 remaining here in the first half. Tate at the free throw line. His first is up and good. He's an 81% free throw shooter. Not the guy we want to see at the line much today. Second shot is up, and it is good. West Florida is 9-14 overall. I mean, in conference play, 13-14 overall. It's a one-point ball game, 13-12. West Alabama leads by one, 13:51 remaining here in the first half. CJ has it on the far side, working around the arc to Allison, to Williams, to Durham. Back to CJ on the far side. CJ dribbles out, gives it to Justin. He shoots a long three. It's up, no good. Battling down low, West Florida comes up with the rebound. DeHart has it. DeHart came up with a rebound as well. They give it on the far side to number three, Latrell Tate. And to the near side, they get it to DeHart. Quickly trying to get it down low with shot clock running out. West Alabama gets a rebound. Allen gets it to the far side, to Williams, to Allison to the near side. He dribbles in, gives it back to CJ. CJ to Allison, wide open three. It's no good. West Florida gets a rebound. Boy, the West Alabama fans are waiting for that big three to happen. And a three coming from West Florida. It goes in the hands of Durham. And out of his hands. West Florida will retain possession. Witherspoon coming in for West Florida. Coran Garner coming in for West Alabama, taking the place of Terry Durham. Tigers lead by one. Garner going under the basket to guard the inbound pass. It's inbounded to Witherspoon. He shoots a three. It's up, no good. Garner gets a rebound. He's going to take it across half court. Kicks it to the far side to CJ. CJ gives it to Williams. Williams back out to Garner. To Melton, back up top. to Garner, back to Melton. Takes a three, he's gonna drive in, loses control of it, it's knocked out of his hand. It's gonna be a turnover. West Florida picks it up. Sofield's taking it down, and he's gonna be called with a travel. 12-13 remaining in the first half. 13-12, your score. West Florida's not scored in the last 4 minutes and 35 seconds, and they're 0 for their last five. Thad's got it, kicks it to Shadarian. Shadarian up top, back to Thad, to the far side, to Justin. Justin takes a step in. They know Justin can shoot it from out there. Back up top to Thad. Thad's working off a screen from Shadarian. Gives it back to Shadarian. He shoots a three. It's short, just off the front of the rim, and West Florida gets the rebound. Rebound by Witherspoon. He gives it to Duhart. Duhart to Sofield. Sofield gives it down low and gives a wide open pass to Witherspoon, where he lays it in for two. West Florida leads 14-13. 11:20 remaining here in the first half. Justin works off a screen from Shadarian. Kicks it out to Thad. Thad dribbles to his right. Hands it off to Coran. Coran to Justin on the far side. He shoots a long three. It's up. It's no good. Rebound, West Florida. Matthews has it. Quickly gives it to Witherspoon. Witherspoon to the far side. Then they lay it down low to Matthews. Matthews misses his shot. Shoots again, misses it. And West Alabama comes up with it. They kick it out to Coran. He shoots a three. It's good. West Alabama leads by two, 16-14. West Florida really slowing it down. The Tigers are playing man-to-man. They get it down low. Then they kick it outside to a wide open Duhart. He shoots a three. It's good. And the score is now 17-16. West Florida leading West Alabama by one. 10-10 remaining in the first half. Coran has it on the right side. Back up top to Thad, to CJ. Over to Justin on the far side, right in front of the West Florida bench. Back up top to Thad. He shoots a long three. That's no good. West Florida comes up with a rebound again. Witherspoon has it. Petit Holm has it up top. Gives it to Sofield. Sofield to Duhart. Then gets it to Witherspoon. He shoots a shot just inside the arc, and it's good. 19-16 your score. West Florida leads with 9:25 remaining. Here in the first half at Pruitt Hall Gymnasium, final regular season game for both of these teams. Tigers are going to the Gulf South Conference Tournament. We're just waiting to see what seed. Pass is put out to Coran. 4 seconds left on the shot clock. He drives in, shots up. Rebound, West Florida. Duhart has it on the far side, slows everything down a little bit. Gives it to Petit Holm. Steal by Shadarian. He's going to take it down, lay it up. It's no good, but a foul on the play, and that foul will be against number 4, Dale Matthews. It'll be his second, team third. And that's going to bring up a media timeout. West Alabama trails 16-19 against West Florida. 8:35 remaining here in the first half. We'll take a 1 minute break on your station for West Alabama basketball, the West Alabama Radio Network. 16-19 your score. West Alabama trails by three, 8:35 remaining here in the first half. In a pivotal game for West Alabama, Valdosta State trails Alabama Huntsville 37-43, 1:23 remaining in the half. Shadarian at the line for the Tigers. His first time at the charity stripe today. Shots up, and it is good. Gets the ball. Next rebound is, next shot is up, no good. West Florida battling for it, and they come up with it. Nakoma has it. He's going to give it out to DeHart. DeHart takes it across and gives it Petit home. DeHart has it, shoots a three, up, no good. Justin tries to get a rebound, but it is taken by Nakoma and knocked back in. 21-17 your score, 18:05 remaining in the first half. Nakoma battling down low, trying to make something happen, and he did. Allison has it up top. Ball is stolen by number 24, Weatherspoon. He's going to drive. He's going to lay it in. And the score is 17-23. West Florida leads, 7:45 remaining here in the first half. Tigers haven't scored a basket in 2 minutes and 41 seconds. As Shadarian Allen shoots a three, and it's no good. Weatherspoon brings it across half court. Gives it to DeHart on the far side. Down low to Nakoma. Back to DeHart. He shoots a three. It's up, no good. Allison gets a rebound, takes it across half court for the Tigers. Thad's going to drive in, and he is going to be fouled. Foul by number three, Latrell Tate. His first, team fourth. And we will have a media timeout. Tigers trail 17-23, 7:12 remaining in the first half. You're listening to West Alabama Basketball on the Best Alabama Radio Network. Welcome back to Pruitt Hall Gymnasium. 7:12 remaining in the first half. West Alabama trails 17-23. Shadarian Allen going to the line for the Tigers. He's 1-for-2 today at the line. Tigers are one of their last eight. Excuse me, not going to the lines. That was inbounded. Terry Durham has it. He's going to lay it in, and the Tigers break that drought as Durham lays it in and making the score 19-23, 7 minutes remaining here in the first half. West Florida gets it down low, and the old-fashioned hook shot from Nakoma gives two more points for West Florida, 25-19, 6:42 remaining in the first half. CJ has it on the far side, gives it to Coran. Back up top to Thad. Thad takes a step, dribbles in, kicks it out to CJ. CJ back to Thad. To Terry at the free throw line. He's going to dribble in. Rough shot, boy, not able to do anything there as that ball is over the basket. West Alabama gets a steal, though, as Shadarian steps in front of a pass the length of the court. He's trapped on the far side, but gets it out to Williams. Williams drives in, shots up and good. 21-25, your new score. 6 minutes remaining in the first half. West Florida is 5 of their last 7. Not a bad shooting day for the Argonauts. Argonauts have it. Quickly, they kick it down low to number 11, Petit Holm, and he dunks it. Makes it a 21-27 ball game. Coran has it, gives it CJ on the far side. He shoots a three, it's up, hits a side of the rim, and it's rebounded by West Florida. Weatherspoon has it, kicks it to the near side of Sofield. He shoots a three, it's up and good, and the score is now 21-30. West Alabama's going to take a 30-second timeout. We're going to take it with them with 5:16 remaining in the first half. You're listening to West Alabama Basketball on the West Alabama Radio Network. West Alabama's got the basketball. 15 seconds left on the shot clock to get it down to Terry. He's double-teamed. Works around, lays it up, and in. Nice move by Terry to break through the double-team. Scores now 23-30. West Alabama trailing by 7. Nakoma has it. He's going to kick it out up top. Gives it to Weatherspoon. Weatherspoon drives in against Durham. Durham blocks the shot. CJ comes up with it. CJ gives it to Durham. He misses the shot as he was trying to lay it in, and West Florida gets it. West Florida has it. Latrell has it down low. CJ blocks a shot. He picks it up, gives it to Shadarian. Shadarian takes a step, goes down, lays it in. Tries to lay it in. Rebound by CJ. Kicks it out to Thad. Thad resets the offense to Coran on the far side. Coran down low to Terry. Back to Coran outside. Shot for three is up. No good. Rebound, Allen. He's trying to take it up, and he's going to be fouled. He's going to go to the line to shoot two. That foul's on number 11, David Petit Holm. And that will be our media timeout. West Alabama trails by 7. 3:56 remaining in a half. We'll take a 1 minute break on the West Alabama Radio Network. Welcome back to Pruitt Gymnasium. West Alabama trails by 7. 3:56 remaining in the first half. Shadarian Allen at the line. He's 1 for 2 today. He will have the shot at 2 free throws here. He gives the little shimmy. Shot's up and good. gets the ball again. Set for his second free throw. Little dribble, shimmy of the shoulders. Shots up and good. Tigers trailed by now 5, 3:56 remaining in the first half. West Florida shooting 46% from the field. This is their last game of the season. No conference tournament for them. Nakoma has it down bottom. He's going to lay it up and in, and West Florida leads by 7 again, 32-25. 3:35 remaining in the half. West Florida back to flirting with shooting 50% so far. Thad's got it up top, gives it to CJ down bottom. He tries to give it to Terry. Terry lets it go. It goes out of bounds. He throws it back in. Shadarian can't get the three, and it's going to be rebound by Latrell. Tate. Tate drives in, spins, lays it back out to Nakoma. Nakoma shoots. It's no good. Williams gets the rebound for West Alabama. Crosses half court. Works off a screen. Gives it to Coran. Back to Thad on the far side. Thad directing the Tigers. He's going to drive in, and he's going to lay an elbow into number three, Latrell Tate, and he's going to be called with the charge. That's his first foul. Team second. Only 7 fouls so far in this ball game with 2:50 remaining. Justin Allen checks back in, taking the place of Coran Garner. 7 fouls in 17 and a half minutes of play. DeHart has it. Gives it to Tate. Up top to Nakoma. Give it again to Tate. Tate dribbles around, gives it to Weatherspoon. He comes back out. He's looking down low, but passes outside to number 12, DeHart. DeHart works off a screen from Nakoma to the outside. They give it to Weatherspoon. He shoots a three. No good. Durham tries to get the rebound, but it's knocked out of bounds by Chenick Nakoma. West Alabama basketball, 2:20 remaining in the half. Tigers trail by 7. Great crowd on hand here. Band cheerleaders down in the end of the new addition to Pruitt Gym. Melton dishes it down low to Durham. Durham lays it in for 2, and the score is 32-27. West Florida quickly working it down. Gets it down low to Nakoma. He's going to his right, to his left, to his right, and they're going to call a block against Terry Durham. He was laying on the ground, and he will be a victim of Nakoma working around him. Nakoma will go to the free throw line for the first time today. He's a 62% free throw shooter. Shots up, and it's good. Today's 1-for-1. Coran comes in, takes Terry's spot. Nakoma at the line. Shots up, goes off the front of the rim. CJ gets the rebound. New score is 27-33, 1:44 remaining in the first half. Coran has it on the near side, drives the baseline, lays it up, and it is in. 29-33, your new score. 1:36 remaining here in the first half. Nakoma has it on the right elbow. He's going to hand it off. He gives it to Tate. The ball's up in the air. Justin has it, throws it back in, but it's picked up by West Florida. DeHart shoots a three, and it is good. And the score is now 36-29, 1:14 remaining in the half. Boy, Tigers can't catch a break here in the past few minutes. Justin looking from way outside, but he's going to work off a screen from Shadarian. Kicks it out to Thad, down low to Shadarian, but it's going to be knocked away and picked up by Nakoma. Sofield has it, dribbling up top, working off a screen from Nakoma. He's going to go to the free throw line, then he's going to kick it across. This ball is just about out of bounds, and it's going to be knocked way up at the ceiling. Very rarely do you see a basketball hit the ceiling in Pruitt Gym, but that is what happened right here. Just about went over the air conditioning ducts. West Alabama will have it nonetheless, and the Tigers will slow things down and try to get a basket here with 39 seconds remaining. Coran to CJ on the near side. Back up top to Coran. To Thad, back to Coran. He shoots a three. It's up, and it's good. 36-32, your new score. 30 seconds remaining in the first half. West Florida. DeHart has it. Takes it to the far side. Taking his time. Going to work this clock down for the final shot. DeHart guarded by Allison. He's going to work off a screen, dribble to the near side. He gives it to Witherspoon. Shots up, no good. Shadarian comes up with it, tries to get it to Coran, but it is not going to make it, and we are at the half. West Alabama ends the half 3 of 3, their last three baskets, but trail 32-36 as we go to the half. Once again, pivotal game in Gulf South Conference play. A lot of action going on around campus. Baseball going on, softball going on. Just a lot of action at West Alabama today. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk to Bria Dent, one of our West Alabama women's basketball players. You're listening to West Alabama Basketball on ESPN 104.9. Welcome back to Pruitt Hall Gymnasium, and I'm joined by one of the stars of the women's basketball team. And I will have to say, she won't admit this, but to me, since I've been here, one of the best basketball players I've seen here. Number two for our women, Bria Dent. Bria, thanks for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
Tough loss today against West Florida. It was we hit a little bit of a drought there in the third quarter where we couldn't get a lot going on, but it's a very tough loss. But against a team that's very good that we very well could have beaten. What was your thoughts on the game?
I think we executed defense to a T. I think, like you said, just came down to who knocked shots down in the end, and they made some shots, and we just couldn't hit at the end of the day.
You're in the Gulf South Conference Tournament, and you've played some of these teams. No one wants to pull us.
Oh, nobody.
Nobody wants to pull us because we can beat anybody in this tournament. So, tournament's coming up, but today was your last game here at Pruitt Hall Gymnasium after 5 years. Tell our Tiger fans about what that was like.
Honestly, it was like a bittersweet moment. You know, I'm happy about the things I accomplished on my journey and the people I met. It's really sad because I made home in Livingston and met so many great, wonderful people. I'm going to miss it. It's a great atmosphere to be in.
You've made a difference in the Gulf South Conference from the beginning. You've come in and has been a big player, and you lead the conference in scoring right now. Talk about what it's been like being a leader on this team.
Definitely at the beginning of the season, it was, you know, some bumps in the road. You know, we have a whole new team. But right now, I would say we at the best point we've been all season as far as the team. We're ready to go to battle. And I think right now, if anybody pulls us, like you said, they'd be scared.
One season is over, but another has begun.
Yeah.
You control your destiny in your hands as you can make it as far as you want to in the conference tournament. Win the tournament, you go to the NCAA tournament. So your fate is literally in your hands. talk about that next step of where we got to go from here.
We just got to go back into practice this week, being optimistic, obviously working on the things we needed to correct from the game, and we got to leave it all on the floor. The effort's there. We don't have to coach this team about effort. We bring that every game. We just got to make sure that we make big plays when it counts.
I'm going to spin it here a little bit. Tell me what you've seen so far in the men's game.
Say that again.
Tell me what you've seen so far in the men's game.
It's tough. I don't think we expected them to come out the way they did, but I think our boys going to pull it out. They always do. They are big-time players.
So it's going to be a lot of fun, and hopefully we'll be cutting some nets down a little later. Bria, I will have to say from my side, thank you for your play. It's been an honor to watch you play, and you play the foundation here. And to see the amount of people that walked out on the court with you at Senior Day is a tribute to who you are. A great person, a great Tiger, not only on the court, but in the classroom. It represents my university as well, so thank you.
Thank y'all. Thank you to all the Livingston fans. Thank you to the coaches I've had, and thank you. You've been great.
So we're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll talk about stats for the first half right here on your West Alabama Radio Network. Welcome back to Pruitt Hall Gymnasium. West Alabama trails West Florida 36-32. West Florida shooting 45% from the field. West Alabama 39%. From beyond the arc, West Florida shooting 45%. West Alabama 27%. From the free throw line, West Florida shooting 75%. West Alabama 67%. The Argonauts has 6 turnovers. West Alabama has 5. West Alabama has 9 points off of those 6 turnovers. West Florida has 5 off of those 5 turnovers. Total rebounds goes to West Florida with 21. West Alabama, 18. Second chance points, West Alabama has 7. West Florida, 4. Bench points, West Florida has 13 points for players off the bench. West Alabama, 8. Points in the paint goes to West Florida, 16. And West Alabama with 12. Fast break points, 7-7. Oh, knotted up there. West Alabama has 3 steals. West Florida has 3 steals. 8 assists for West Florida, 6 assists for West Alabama. The game's been tied twice. Lead changed 4 times. Let's go to the leading scores. Leading scorer for West Florida is Nakoma with 7. Matthews has 6 rebounds, and he also has 2 assists. For West Alabama, Coran Gardner has 8 points. Shadarian has 5 rebounds, and Thad leads the teams in assists with 4. The largest lead for West Alabama was 3. Largest run was 8. And the last field goal was with 29 seconds left. That was a three-pointer by Coran. Largest run for West Florida was 6. Largest lead was 9. And West Florida leads now by 4, 36-32. Once again, a great crowd on hand here. Let's check over to the Alabama Huntsville game, where the Chargers lead 57-44 with 16:49 remaining in the second half. Another big game there in Gulf South Conference play. West Georgia will be playing, the women will be playing a little bit later today. That's going to be a big game for West Alabama's women to find out where they will be playing in the Gulf South Conference tournament. Tournament will start this Tuesday, and the men are locked in to play right here at home. 6:30 here. Broadcast will be brought here by Will Atkinson. I'll be moving back over to the PA spot. And it should be a ruckus crowd here. We want everybody here for that game. Should be a lot of fun. And let's get a good first round win and move on to Birmingham to play in the Gulf South Conference championships. West Alabama is number 4 in the region, so the Tigers got some work to do to get on up there to play in the regional tournament. But a win here will help the Tigers make that step even more. Once again, softball's playing, baseball's playing, a lot of things going on. I want to say hello to Troy Maddox and all the crew out at baseball, making everything happen out there, and everybody at softball getting everything together, getting all these events happening. We have a ton of things going on. Tennis playing on campus as well. There's a lot of things happening everywhere. So if you're a Tiger fan, you haven't seen the Tigers play today, you're missing out, because you can see a little bit of everything. 36-32, your score. We're going to take a break on your West Alabama Radio Network. Welcome back to Pruitt Gymnasium. Just about a minute left until we take the court again here for the second half, the final game of the regular season. Not the final game here for West Alabama men's basketball in Pruitt Gym, because the Tigers will play the first round of the Gulf South Conference tournament here this Tuesday night at 6:30. We're just waiting on the seating. Both teams to their sidelines are getting their final instructions from their coaches. Great crowd on hand here for a Saturday afternoon. West Alabama trails by four, 36-32. About to get things back underway. West Florida will receive the ball to start this game. Inbounding it is Latrell Tate right here in front of us at half the court. West Florida will be going left to right on your radio dial. Tate throws it into DeHart. DeHart guarded closely by Allison, dribbles it to his right, back to his left. He's looking down low. Throws it down low, it's kicked back out. Shot by number four, Matthews. And Durham is going to be the man that's going to get that foul. That's going to be his third, team first. Only four fouls against West Alabama so far in this ball game. Five for West Florida. Matthews goes to the line, first time for the day. Shots up, no good. CJ's got it, gives it to Durham. He's going to go down. And he's going to lay it in for two. And he will go to the line for an old-fashioned three. Foul by number four, Dale Matthews. That'll be his third, team first. Terry's one for two at the line today. Eyes the rim, shots up, and he gets the old-fashioned three. 38-35, your score. West Florida has it. DeHart dribbles to his right. Gives it to Tate. Tate back to DeHart. Up top to Matthews. Matthews gives it to Tate as he goes around. Shots up and shots good. Tate went all the way around. Did a complete circle under the basket. Got the ball and was able to score. Makes it a five-point ball game again. 40-35, 19 minutes left. Allison has it on the far side. Dad has it now, gives it to Shadarian. Back to Allison. He shoots a three. It's up and good. The Tigers have been waiting on that. The score is now 40-38, 18:42 remaining in the half. DeHart has it, dribbles to his left, gets his instructions from his coach. Steal by Durham. Durham gives it to Allison. Allison dribbling down to the left. Gives it to Durham, he lays it in. And we've got a tied ball game, 40-40. And we've got a timeout on the court. That will be a media. We'll take it with them, all tied up 40-40. 18:14 remaining here in this ball game. Shots up and no good by DeHart. West Alabama gets a rebound. 18 minutes remaining. 40-40 your score. Try to get it down low to Terry, but it's picked up by West Florida. Quickly, they get it to the far side. The shot is up and no good by Sofield. West Alabama gets a rebound. Justin gives it to Thad. Thad works it to the left, gives it to Shadarian. Shadarian works off a screen from CJ. Kicks it out to Allison. Allison dribbles to his right. Gives it to the corner to CJ. Back to the far side to Thad. Thad shoots a long three. It's up, no good. Rebound. Shadarian saves it. Gives it to Thad. Drives in. Kicks it back out to Shadarian. He shoots a long two. It's good. And we have a foul away from the shot. Basket's good. Foul on number four. That's a fourth foul on Dale Matthews. Team second. Matthews will go out. Nakoma comes in. Early to get your fourth. 42-40, West Alabama leads. They give it to Shadarian. He shoots a three, no good. Justin gets a rebound. To Thad on the near side. He dribbles in, works off a screen from Terry. Back outside to Shadarian. Shadarian takes a shot. It's up, rattles around, no good. Rebound, West Florida. DeHome gets it. And that ball is tipped, picked up by Nakoma. Kicked out to number 21, Sofield. Sofield takes a jumper. It's up, no good. Rebound, Nakoma. And no, they're going to say a foul. No shot. Foul on number 34, Channing Nakoma, his first, team third. Grant Gardner coming into the game. Gardner coming into the game for West Alabama. Tennis team coming in to Pruitt. Justin has the ball, dribbles to his our left, gives it to Coran. Down low to Shadarian. Shadarian drives baseline, throws it to Thad. His shot is blocked and picked up by West Florida. He's going to drive the length of the court. He's going to lay it in. That was number 21, Daniel Sofield. 42-42, your score. 16:09 remaining in this last regular season game. For both of these teams, the Tigers will move on to the conference tournament and play here Tuesday night. West Florida will go home and start thinking of next year. Thad takes a shot. It's up. No good. Nakoma gets the rebound. He's going to give it to DeHart. DeHart dribbles to his right, to his left, back to his right. Dribbles back out. Thinks better of it. Gives it to Petit Home. Home to Nakoma. Hands it to Tate. Tate drives in, shoots. Shot is up and no good. Tate fighting for the rebound. And we're going to have a foul against Shadarian. That'll be his first, team second. 42-42 your score, 15:26 remaining in the game. We'll take a break right here on the West Alabama Radio Network.
42-42, 15:26 remaining. West Alabama all knotted up with West Florida.
I'm Jason Gardner. Philip Aiken here helping with production. Wayne Grant back in the studio. Quick inbound is shot by West Florida. Sofield on the shot, and it's rebounded by the Tigers. Allison has it, brings it across the half court for the Tigers. Gives it to Gardner. Back to Allison. He dribbles up top, gives it to Thad. Thad looking to his right, gives it to Allison. Back to his left. He shoots a long three. It's up, no good. Rebound, West Florida. Petit Holm comes up with it. He quickly gives it to Tate. Shots up and no good. Rebound, Williams. It's knocked away. Allison comes up with it. Gives it to CJ on the far corner. Back up to Allison, to Thad. Works it all the way around. Coran's going to take a baseline. Kicks it out to CJ. CJ drives in. Out to Thad. Thad back to CJ. CJ takes a shot. Hits up. No good. Shadarian gets a rebound. His shot is blocked by Sofield. Shadarian gets it back. Shots up. No good. Rebound. Petit Holm. West Florida is one of their last seven. Make that one of their last eight as Shadarian gets the rebound. West Alabama is one of their last 10. Tigers are on a 252 scoring drought. Neither team shooting well here in the beginning of the second half. Thad to the far side to Allison. He shoots a three. It's up. No good. West Alabama on a 3-minute, 15-second scoring drought. West Florida on a 2-minute, 16-second scoring drought. West Florida has it on the far side. Tate dribbles around. He's going to drive to the basket. Shots up. No good. Shadarian has it, but it's knocked out of bounds by Latrell Tate. Tigers will have the ball. Taking our time putting the ball into play here. 42-42, 13:29 remaining. Thad has it, gives it to Coran up top. Coran working off a screen from CJ to Justin on the left side. Back up top to Coran. Coran down low to Terry. Terry dribbles in, and he's going to be called with a charge. Terry Durham picks up his fourth foul. Third overall. I can't argue with that one as Terry kind of lowered his shoulder a little bit as he was going around to the basket. ...42-42, 13:07 remaining. DeHart has it. They give it up top to Tate. Tate dribbles to his right. Back to his left. Throws it down low. Shots missed by number 11, Petit Holm. West Alabama comes up with it. Back to CJ. Picked up by Thad as the ball's been all around. And that's not a good look as West Alabama's. Thad Williams goes down as well as one of the Argonauts. They were both knotted up together. Fouls on number 34, Channing Nakoma, his second, team fourth. Nakoma's on his knee. Thad is up, walking around. Neither one. Look like they're feeling that well. Both took nasty falls. Be honest, looked like both of their knees in some ways were locked up around each other. Looked like they both took twist. So we're getting the sweat off the floor. 434 is your scoring drought for the Tigers. 335, your scoring drought for West Florida. West Alabama's last field goal was 17-15 mark. West Florida's last field goal was a 16-16 mark. neither seem to want to score. Or the basket doesn't want it to happen to one. Coran has it on the far side, gives it to Thad up top. Thad dribbles to his left to Justin. Justin to Shadarian, back to Justin up top. 12 seconds left on the shot clock. Justin's going to dribble down to the baseline, kick it out to Coran. He takes a step, shoots, shot's no good. Rebound, West Florida. Coran comes up with it. Actually, Thad's on the floor. West Florida gets the ball, and it is up and missed by number 21, Sofield. They're going to call Justin with the foul. His first, team fourth. Your score. Going to the line, number 21, Daniel Sofield. Sofield's first time at the line today, and he misses. Peter Terrell coming into the game for West Alabama. Peter Terrell from London, England. Steps into the block. Sofield shots up and good. Breaks the tie, 43-42. Justin has it. Gives it to Coran to the near side. Swings it around to Shadarian. Back up top to Coran to Justin. To Sharan at the free throw line. He shoots. It's up and it's good. West Alabama leads 44-43, and West Alabama breaks that 5 minute and 2 second scoring drought. 11:46 remaining. Defense chance going strong by West Alabama as they give it down low to Nakoma. Still by West Alabama. CJ Melton has it. And as he crosses half court, he's going to be knocked down by Nakoma. That will be a foul against number 34. His third, team fifth. We will take the media, 44-43. West Alabama leads by one, 11:33 remaining in the game. You're listening to West Alabama basketball on the West Alabama Radio Network.11:33 remaining in the game. West Alabama leads 44-43 against West Florida. West Alabama, the number 24 team in the nation. As Justin Allison gets it, dribbles to his left. Tigers are going right to left on your radio dial. Justin has it. Works off a screen from Shadarian. Gives it to the far side to Coran. Back to Justin near side. He shoots a three. It's up. No good. Rebound Coran on the far side. New shot clock for the Tigers. 15 seconds left on the shot clock. 11:12 remaining in the game. Coran shoots a three. It's up. It's no good. Rebound West Florida. DeHart comes up with it. He takes it across half court, guarded closely by Coran. Dribbles to his left. Looking at who to give it to. Gives it to Matthews. Matthews dribbles to his left. Gives it to the far side to Sofield. Sofield comes back up top, guarded by Peter. And we've got a charge. They give it to Matthews. And that is Matthews' fifth foul. He is headed to the bench.
and that is the sixth foul against West Florida. Their coach, not a happy camper at all. West Alabama leads 44-43, 10:45 remaining. Coran has it. Gives it to Justin as he crosses midcourt. Tigers have the possession arrow. Three timeouts left for West Alabama, two for West Florida. Justin drives in, lays it up, it's up and good. West Alabama leads 46-43, 10:24 remaining. West Florida still has not scored a basket in 5 minutes and 41 seconds. One of their last 10, zero of their last six. They're down low. They give it to Weatherspoon. Weatherspoon steps back out, has it up top. Shot by Peter. It's no good. Air ball. Justin comes up with it. Justin takes it across half court. Gives it to CJ. CJ kicks it out to Coran. He shoots a three. It's good. West Alabama leads 49-43, 9:45 remaining, and the Tigers have come to life. We're going to take a break as the Tigers lead 49-43 on your West Alabama Radio Network. West Alabama's on a 7-0 run over the last 2 minutes and 13 seconds. West Florida hasn't scored a basket in 2 minutes and 29 seconds. Tigers have taken advantage of this 100%. West Alabama leads 49-43 as they try to win a share, at least a share, of the Gulf South Conference Championship from the regular season. As of right now, 2:40 remaining up in Huntsville. The Chargers lead 91-78. West Florida has the ball. As they dribble to the near side. DeHart has it. Get Tate. Tate shoots. He shoots it over Coran, and that's good. They break the drought. 49-45, your new score. 9:15 remaining. Justin has it on the near side, works off a screen from Peter, and they're going to call a foul. That foul's on number 12, Jared DeHart. That'll be his first, team second. We'll send Justin Allison to the line, shooting 1-1. This is Justin's first trip to the free throw line today. On the court for the Tigers, Peter Turay, Coran Gardner, Justin Allison, C.J. Melton, and Shadarian Allen. 9:04 remaining. First shot's up and good. Tigers have come alive as of late. Justin's second free throw is up and good. 51-45, your new score, 9 minutes remaining. The defense chant echoes throughout Pruitt Gym. Weatherspoon dribbles in. He kicks it out to Tate. Tate goes to the far side, guarded closely by CJ. Tate kicks it to number 12,
DeHart, he shoots. It's up, no good. But it's put back in by number 24, Weatherspoon. 51-47 your score. Justin has it, kicks it around to Coran. He just about loses it. Works off a screen from Peter. Gives it to Justin on the far side. 9 seconds left on the shot clock, 7. Justin shoots, shot's good! With a hand in his face. Daniel Sofield was all over him, and Justin puts it in. The score is now 53-47, 8 minutes remaining. Tigers win. They at least get a share of the regular season title. They kick it out to DeHart. His shot's no good. CJ comes up with a rebound. 7:45 remaining. And the ball is thrown out of bounds, and it'll be West Florida's basketball. We're at the 8-minute media timeout. We'll take it with them. Tigers lead 53-47. 7:41 remaining in the game. You're listening to West Alabama Basketball on the West Alabama Radio Network. Tate goes up for the shot, and he's going to be fouled by Coran. Tate will go to the free throw line. That's Coran's first, team fifth. 53-47, I'm Jason Garner, bringing you this West Alabama game against West Florida, playing for the Gulf South Conference regular season title. West Georgia has defeated Delta State 73-55. Auburn Montgomery leads Montevallo 78-66 with 8 minutes remaining. Free throw is up and good. 53-49, your new score. CJ has it up top. Dribbles, takes a step in. Looks to the near side to Coran. He shoots a three. It's good. 56-49, your new score. 7:07 remaining. West Florida has it, guarded closely by West Alabama. Tate has Coran Gardner all over him. He shoots it. They're going to call a foul on Coran after the ball didn't go through. So that's a foul on Coran Gardner, his second, team sixth. Tiger fans not happy with the call, even after replay was shown. Latrell Tate at the free throw line. He's 4 for 4 today. From the charity stripe. First one's up and good, 5 for 5. 6:50 remaining. Tigers up by six. Free throw is up and good. We've got a 56-51 ball game, 6:50 remaining. Tate just picked up his 10th point of the game. Thad brings it across half court. He dribbles to his left right in front of the West Alabama coaching staff. Works off a screen to Shadarian to the near side, gives it to Coran. Back to Thad. He dribbles to his left, gives it to Shadarian. To Coran to the near side, down low to CJ. CJ backs it down, works around, takes his shot, rattles around, no good. Rebound Shadarian, lays it back in, and the score is now 58-51. Defense! 6:08 remaining in the game. West Alabama up by seven. West Florida has it on the far side. Weatherspoon. They give it to DeHart. Pass is stolen by Shadarian. He gives it to CJ. CJ lays down the hammer. 60-51. 5:46 remaining in the game, and the Tiger fans are on their feet. DeHart on the near side. Gives it up top to Sofield. Sofield's shot is no good. Garner gets it. He's going to take it back across half court. Slows everything down, gives it to Thad. 60-51 your score. 5:22 remaining in the game. Tigers are six of their last seven. Coran has it on the near side. Shoots the three. It's good. Coran is feeling it. 5:06 remaining in the game. 63-51. He is on fire. We've got a timeout. We will take it with them. You're listening to West Alabama basketball on the West Alabama Radio Network. Five minutes remaining in the game. West Alabama leads 63-51. Tigers on a 7-0 run, three of their last three. West Florida has the basketball to our right. They give it up top to Sofield. He's guarded closely by Shadarian. It's knocked away by Shadarian. Thad picks it up. He takes it to the basket, lays it in for two. And the score is now 65-51. West Florida has it again. Give it to Tate. Tate's guarded by CJ. They dish it off to Petit Holm. He lays it in, and the score is now 52-65. That ends a long scoring drought for West Florida. 4 minutes remaining in the game. West Alabama leads 65-52. We have a final in Huntsville. The Chargers, 93. Valdosta State, 81. Thad drives in, gives it down to Peter. Peter shots up and good. 67-52, your new score. The shot for West Florida is up and good. 3:26 remaining. 67-52 your score. Coran takes it across half court. 3:12 remaining in the game. And we have a foul on number 12, Jared DeHart, his second, team eighth. And we will have a media timeout. West Alabama leads 67-55, 3:07 remaining in the game. You're listening to West Alabama basketball on the West Alabama Radio Network. West Alabama comes into today's game ranked number 24 in the nation as they take on the University of West Florida. The Tigers lead 67-55, 3:07 remaining in the game. Alabama Huntsville has won, so West Alabama needs the win to get a share of the regular season title. Coran Garner at the line. Coran's first time to the free throw line today. Shots up and good. The junior from Huntsville, Alabama, eyes the line again. Takes a dribble. Shots up. No good. Rebound. West Florida. Witherspoon has it. Gives it to DeHart. DeHart dribbles to his right. Works off a screen from Petit Holmes. They give it to Tate. He loses it, gets it back, takes it down low, and we're going to have a foul called. Foul number 0, Shadarian Allen. That'll be Shadarian's second, team 7th. Tate at the line. Front end of the 1-1 is good. 2:53 remaining. ...68-56 the score. Second shot's no good. Shadarian rebounds it, but he's going to step on the line, and it's going to be West Florida's basketball. West Alabama shooting 44% from the field, 41% for West Florida. West Florida has it. Petit Holmes takes a shot. It's up. It's good. And the score is now 58-68. 2:40 remaining in the game. It's a 10-point ball game. Thad has it on the far side. Gives it to Justin. They just about strip it away from him, but he keeps it. He dribbles back up top. Looking to his right. Drives in. Looking for some help. Works off a screen from CJ. Gives it to Coran. He drives to the basket. Kicks it out to Thad. Nice pass. Three. It's good. 71-58 your score. 2:11 remaining in the game. Nice look and sweet shot by Thad Williams. Petit home with a three. It's good. With 2 minutes left, we have a 10-point ball game. CJ takes it baseline. Dribbles back out, gives it to Thad.
He is back outside. West Florida trapping Thad. He gets it over to the near side to Justin. Justin dribbles, takes it into the basket, shots up, no good. Rebound, West Florida. DeHart takes it. He's going to kick it out to the far side to Weatherspoon. He's going to shoot a two. It's good. And the score is 63-71, 1:21 remaining. Shedarian loses it. Picks up by CJ. And West Alabama gets a timeout. We'll take it with them. West Alabama leads by 8. 1:17 remaining. Welcome back, 1:17 remaining in the game. 71-63, your score. West Alabama leads West Florida. Curran will inbound it in front of the scorer's table. Gets it to Thad. Thad gets it across half court. Dribbles across half court, guarded closely by Sofield. Gets it to Justin in the near side, back center to Thad. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Thad dribbles in, takes it to the basket, kicks it out to Justin. Justin shoots a three. It's good. Nothing but the bottom of the net. West Alabama was struggling with the shot clock there. But big points comes out of that, 74-63. As Tate shoots it from the far side, around the basket it goes in, and the score is 74-66, 40 seconds remaining. They're trapping Justin on the far side. He gets it to Darian. To Curran on the near side. 32 seconds remaining in the game, and Curran's going to be fouled by number 30. 21, Daniel Sofield. That'll be his first, team ninth. 32 seconds left in the game. 30 seconds on the shot clock. Curran goes to the free throw line. Shots up, and it's no good. West Florida has it. Weatherspoon kicks it out to Sofield. He misses it. Justin gets the rebound. He's going to give it to Shedarian as the Tiger fans are on their feet. Shedarian dribbles it to the free throw line, dribbles back out. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, West Alabama wins 74-66 and is a regular season, has a share of the regular season Gulf South Conference Championship. And the net will be coming down here in Pruitt Hall. New nets will be had for the game this Tuesday night. Coach Nick Woodruff coming up to join us to talk for a minute before we start to cut down some nets. Well, I thought he was. '74-66, your score. West Alabama will go in to the game Tuesday night with a share of the regular season championship. Coach Woodruff coming up. We're going to talk to him for a second as the team has the trophy at midcourt. Coach Nick Woodruff with us. Coach, congratulations on another regular season conference championship.
Man, thank you so much. That is really, really hard to do. Really, really hard to do, and we proved it tonight, which is, this is the last game of the year, and West Florida wasn't going to go down easy.
Right.
And, you know, they're making shots, and we did not come out with the same intensity and juice that we came out with on Thursday, but, man, we figured it out. Thank you, bud. Thank you. Love you. All right. And
Hugs coming from everywhere for winning the championship.
It's just so hard to do. And, man, this group of guys, and I can't say enough about Fat and Justin and CJ. I'll get emotional. I've been just these last few days of practice, I've been just like gravitating towards them just to soak it all in, because those two guys, regardless of what they do on the floor, scoring it or in the box score, more than anything, they are winners.
Right.
Winners. And you can't have enough winners on your team. And, man, that's a big-time win for our program. It's never been done back-to-back in the history of West Alabama. And all the credit goes to these guys, because we could not have done it without Fat, Justin, CJ coming back and leading this team.
Well, Coach, we got some nets to cut down, but first I want to ask you, just talk to our fans about Tuesday night. We'll play at 6:30. What a big game here. We need everybody here. We need
new season starts on Tuesday. It's a new season. You go and have to play somebody that's trying to fight to stay in and not put the shoes up. And we just got to keep fighting. And we're like, you know, like Peter stepping up here in the second half tonight, like made big time plays and did it. Like, it's just the next man up, next guy up. We've got a great bench of guys, great group of guys that have been through it. And I heard something, I think Coach K said it. He said it's not about the destination, but it's about the journey. And this journey that we've been on has been really, really enjoyable. And I'm not ready to shut it down, and I hope they're not either. I hope we can keep playing for a while.
And there should be a good chance. These are really good wins for a region birth as well. So,
yep.
Coach, go cut some nets down.
Let's go cut them down. Yep, appreciate it. Thank you.
That's Coach Nick Woodruff as West Alabama wins 74-66. And the nets are about to come down here at Pruitt Hall. Next up, West Alabama will play in the first round of the Gulf South Conference Tournament. And we'll play here at Pruitt Hall, 6:30 here at Pruitt. We're waiting to find out who our opponent will be. That will be sent out later tonight. So everybody come out this week. Have a great time. And let's pack this place. And let's take a step towards the Gulf South Conference Championship. West Alabama wins 74-66. For Wayne Grant back in the studio, Philip Aiken here working production. I'm Jason Gardner. Have a great night, everybody, and as always, go Tigers.